Now, Ferdinand, what about the farm in BC? Because I understand that you have apprentices there.
Yeah, we are, of course, a mini outfit. I go by what my father always said to me, you should not have to eat the whole cake to find out how good it is. The bigger, more of the cake you have to eat, the dumber you are. So we have a very small slice of this business, if you can call it that way. It is the education of farmers or apprentices to go into biodynamics.
Uh-huh.
And I have learned with this a wonderful lesson that you can do it with 10 to 15 apprentices and you can be profitable. You can be profitable, mm-hmm. because our farm only has, our land is 20 acres and my daughter has 10. So together we have 30 and there is enough to do. Falling of trees, planting trees, seeds also, two vegetables on 2 acres. We have some cattle there, we have horses, we have chickens. We have everything with which the student, when he then leaves, will be come into contact.
Yeah, familiar.
Yes, mm-hmm. And we have fences that are cut to break the wind. We have also electrical wires, high voltage wires, where we can show what it means when you spray against this radiation.
Oh yes, yes, yes.
A electrical power grid that goes across your farm attracts always atomic residues. It's like a vacuum cleaner.
Yeah.
And it's not so much the electricity and the magnetism that causes harm. It is what you have as the atomic fallout. And that's what is attracted underneath the electrical power lines.
Wow.
And mm-hmm. so this, of course, has to be neutralized if you want to continue. And the biodynamic preparations, they can do that.
Yeah.
So that we can also show, people come with a Geiger counter, look at it, how does it look further down?
There you go.
Up, yeah.
Yeah.
We